Hi guys, Ashley here. I am your China marketing expert, and in my videos I talk about China, marketing and leadership. Today is the second day of the new year. Woohoo! In fact, it's not just the new year, it is also the new decade. And today I would like to share with you a review format that I'm using to review my years that I've been using for 3 years this far. And it's an incredibly powerful tool to plan ahead and also to look back at the year that you had, and in our case also the decade that we had. So today I would like to talk to you about that, in hopes that for those of you that have not done the review yet, you will spend those 30 minutes and do it. And for those of you that have done the review, maybe you'll find something interesting here to improve your way to do the review. Okay? So let's jump into that right away. First of all, when you are reviewing your year, this year, I prefer to start with a bigger picture, with a decade in review. And this is our step number one. We are going to look at the decade in review. So think about yourself. Back in 2009, where were you? Maybe you were still a student. Maybe you were just doing your first job, right? And I would like you to really think about, what are your biggest accomplishments for the past decade? And by the way, when I say accomplishments, accomplishment is anything, any result that you're proud of. So maybe you got married, maybe you completed your university studies, maybe you started a business, maybe you earned $1 million, we don't know. What it is you're proud about. So write those things down, the more the better, and circle 10 things that really pop up and stand out. You will see how much you've actually progressed in the past 10 years. Extremely important. Second step, we are going to do our year in review. We're going to look at 2019, and here are three questions that I would like you to answer. The first question is exactly the same as above. We're going to look at the major accomplishments, which means the best results, the results that you're proud of in the past year. And here I invite you to look at a couple of areas of life, for example health, for example business, for example money, for example your growth and education. Just look at all those different areas, family and friends, etc., etc., and write 5, 6, 10 things that you are really, really proud of in the past year. For me, for instance, in my two-sheet review, this is the section that is the longest. So some of the things that I'm proud of, for instance, I moved to a new great apartment, and right now I published 4 mini books, and I took my parents-in-law to holidays in Russia, and I'm proud of running the mentorship program for women, etc., etc. You just write it all down and you will also feel so super fulfilled how amazing your year in fact was. The next step after that is you write down the biggest lessons you learned this past year. So we are all constantly growing. We constantly learn lessons from business, from life. We change, and it is important to write those lessons down so they would really be kind of written in stone in many ways, so you will not forget them. So what are your major learnings? What are those lessons that you learned? For me, I wrote down everything is possible when you believe in it. Yeah, so it sounds obvious, but for me it's really meaningful right now because I've seen what the power of belief and the power of thinking big and acting big and daring, what it actually does to you. So for me it is a big, big lesson. And another one is think in the morning, act in the afternoon. So don't wait until that perfect situation or perfect day. It's really, you thought about something, you had this beautiful idea in the morning, in the afternoon you go and execute it, you act on it. And the next one is, people is everything, right? People's everything, and personal brand is the power. Keep growing it by giving first. So these are some of the lessons that I wrote. What are your lessons? I invite you to really write them down. And the third one in this section is, I ask you to mark on a scale from 1 to 10 your various areas of life within that 1 year. For instance, such areas as mind and meaning, or your health and vitality. So is it a 1 or is it a 10? How happy, in other words, how happy are you with that area of your life in the past year? Or friends and family, or personal growth, or business, or wealth, or celebration, or contribution, right? Just write them all down. And the final section would be, what is your total score for the year? So year 2019, was it for you a 7 out of 10, a 9 out of 10, a 3 out of 10, and why? For me, for instance, I wrote it was a 9 out of 10, a phenomenal year, an awesome year, fun and fulfilling one, right? So what it is for you. Next, we go to step number 3. Step number 3 is all about your accomplishments in 2020. In other words, what do you want to achieve this next year? So step number 3, you want to, first of all, ask, what do you want to accomplish next year, such as this will be your best year yet? In other words, looking at all these areas of life, health, family, friends, business, money, etc. How can you make 2020 10 out of 10 on all those areas? And you just start writing. Think big, right? Do you want to, for example, for me, number one, keep enjoying my life and business to the fullest. Have tons of fun every single day. That's very important. Another one is to grow my business to a certain amount of money, right? And take certain return on investment. The other one is to grow my personal brand 10 times and enter more international, not just Asian arena. Significantly improve my peer group, for instance, etc., etc. So write all of these things down. Number two, within this step, you are answering another question. What new habits can you cultivate to help achieve those goals? So is it that you're going to be waking up earlier every day? Is it that you're going to be reading 5 pages every day? Is it that you're going to be, you know, again, training for some new skill, or you're going to become healthier, you're going to change the way you eat, or you're going to change the way you, what you focus on, or your peer group, or whatever else. So write down some of those habits. And number three within this step is, what are your immediate next steps to achieve these goals, right? So what can you do right now, starting right now? Then we're moving to the next step, step number four. And step, big step number four is, in 2020, I am. So you essentially don't just give yourself the goals, what do you want to achieve in 2020, but you also identify your vision for yourself. Who do you want to be in 2020? For me, for instance, I say I'm a force for good in this world. I say that I'm an extraordinary friend and life partner to my husband. I say that I'm a fun haver and the most inspirational entrepreneur that I know, that I'm having a phenomenal peer group, that I'm a physical goddess, etc., etc. Just write down, who do you want to be in 2020 in order to have the most fun, in order to enjoy it the most. And the final step, step number 5, will be your top 5 outcomes for the next year, 2020. Some people like top 3 outcomes. I prefer top 5. It's up to you. So essentially, what are some of the things that you really want to achieve and accomplish in 2020? So for example, for me, I say I want to enjoy every moment, always have fun in life and business. So that's my number one outcome. If I achieve that, I'm already super, super, super happy. Number two, I want to take X amount of dollars in dividends from my business. The next one, I want to grow a certain product to a certain amount, etc., etc. Just write your biggest outcomes. What are the things that you would really want to accomplish, if nothing else, within this year? So this is my way to review a year and a decade, and I've been doing it for the past 3 years, I believe, and every time it is the most fulfilling experience. I hope that this is going to help you also do your year in review maybe a bit better. And also, if you have any suggestions how to improve it, or maybe you already came up with your outcomes that you would like to share, that you would like to announce publicly, please do so. I would first of all love to read them. To also, you will inspire me, and I would absolutely love to see your tips on how to make my review also better. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Looking forward to chat with you soon, and enjoy.